Good morning, students. In the last class, I was talking about web pages. Now, this web pages is actually created using a language that is HTML, Hypertext Markup Language. And this web pages, as we know, that contain text, audio, video, images, and also these pages we can only access through the web browser only. Now in this web pages, sometime we have seen different links are there. That link sometime that might be a text, that might be a picture. So that links is actually known as hyperlinks. This hyperlinks will allow us to go to the another page that is related to the current web page. So a web page contains some links that allow us to go to other pages also that is related to the current page. So that is known as hyperlink. Whenever we are dragging our mouse pointer on that hyperlinks, by clicking there, we can go to the other pages also. That is correlated of these pages. So this hyperlink may be a text or maybe a picture. Now I'm going to show the example of this hyperlinks, but before that I'm discussing the website also, and then I'm going back to the examples with this hyperlink definition. And now this website. Website is now the collection of all these related web pages that is linked to each other. And we know that the first page always, whenever we open a website, there will be always a first page, and that first page of that website is known as the home page. And we see that in the home page also there are multiple pictures are there, some text over there, some links over there. So that by clicking over there, we can directly go to that particular pages or window, go to the other new pages or new windows. So that is known as hyperlinks. That links are known as hyperlink. So all of this makes a website. So we can say in a simple word that this website is nothing but a collection of all these interconnected web pages. Now I'm going to show you one example of this. Like if I'm talking about our school website, like scmemorialschool.com, whenever you open this, so we can say this scmemorialschool.com, this enter one is a website, and that contains web pages that is interconnected to each other. How? Like here you can see some buttons are there, like download requisition form, login, admission status. So all these things are hyperlink, because whenever we are clicking to that particular button, that will allow us to go to the another page or to the another new window we can access. So that is actually hyperlink. So all these are making a website. So whenever we will click on this login, then we will directly go to that login pages. So that is a different web page, we can say. And this all this collection of this web pages making a school website, that is scmemorialschool.com. Because whenever we are clicking on this login, that is something other web page. And whenever we are clicking on admission status, that is also on another web page. So for all of these options, we are going to other pages. But this web pages is under this scmemorialschool.com. So we can say this is school, this is the website, and these are the hyperlinks. And this hyperlink can be text, either image, and that allow us to go to different web pages. I hope so it is more or less clear, this concept. Now next topic is URL. That is also correlated to the previous topics. So each website or web pages, we can say, that has some unique address, and that is known as URL or Uniform Resource Locator. because if all the website has same name, we can't recognize if your school website will be same and you suppose any other website also same, then how can you recognize that this is your school website, right? So like I'm giving here also one example, that is www.microsoft.com. So each of the website, like Google, when we want to search in Google, we type www.google.com. For opening Gmail, we write www.gmail.com. So in this way, all these website or web pages have different address, and that is known as URL. So this enter one is known as URL. So URL contain of these three terms, that is HTTP, www and .com. www you already know, that is World Wide Web, that indicating the site that is on the World Wide Web. HTTP actually tells the computer that it how to communicate with the internet computer, and .com is indicating the commercial site. So this enter thing making a URL. Now, by different web browser, we can access to the internet. Now here I have shown the components of the Internet Explorer window. I think all of you know about the Internet Explorer. So what are the components of that Internet Explorer window? But before going to that part, first we will know that how we can open the Internet Explorer. For that, first we will go to the search bar and write Internet Explorer. See, here is my Internet Explorer. So I will click on this and open it. So this is, in this way we can open Internet Explorer window. Now we will get to know what are the components of this Internet Explorer window. First, start with the address bar. This address bar actually appears at the top of the window, and it actually allows us to write the URL of the particular website. And after entering the URL, we can access that particular website. So always whenever we need to write the URL of any website or web pages, we always write in the address bar. And by clicking on enter, then we can search for any website. After that back button, that allow us to go back to the previous pages that I recently visited. So here also I have shown one example, that which one is back button. So this is our back button. So by clicking on that, I can go back to the previous page. Next is forward button. So that just the opposite of it. We can go to the next page where we are currently working on. So by clicking on that forward button, we can go to the next page. Here I have also added the forward button picture. So this is our forward button. Okay. Next, come to the refresh button. That allows us to get the updated version of any website or web pages. So whenever we need to reload the web pages, we always press this icon, that is refresh button, that allows us to get the updated version of any web page. Now after that, favorites button. So what about the favorite button? So favorite buttons actually used to save the URL or any address of the web pages that we need that we suppose we need to visit later any web pages. So in that case, we can make that particular URL favorite, and later we can access those particular pages. So this favorite button will help me to make any web pages to visit later. So this is more or less about today. Thank you. Have a good day, everyone.